If I could say anything about Wood Middle School, it's that we believe in collaboration.
Never been at a school where we were so focused on the goals, really collecting data.
The resources that we're getting, especially with all the technology, has helped me with my teaching, and I think it's made the kids a lot more involved.
I like having a challenge, and so I sign up for these hard classes, and it definitely is a challenge.
I had never seen such focused and such concerned teachers.
We're starting to show data in the classroom so students themselves can see, hey, this is where we're at, guys.
Are we there yet completely? No, but it's a progression, and people are getting better at it every day. We want to be talking about teaching and learning all the time.
What strategies are we using with our Hispanic students? Obviously,
giving students interventions when they need it, giving students acceleration as they need it, and really meeting the needs of the student learner. So it's not just about teaching, but it's about what kids are learning specifically. And that, I think, is the most important thing about a professional learning community, because you're working on how are kids learning.
We're much more interactive with our teaching now. When I first started teaching, teachers were more the sage on the stage, a lot of lecture. Now we're more of the guide on the side, building relationships with students, using interactive technology to engage students. Really, that's the key.
The electric current is running through it.
So with these ActiveVotes, it's giving you instant data to start making decisions about your instruction.
If I can assess my kids and get immediate feedback, I can totally change my lesson around before the end of the day.
We can use warm-ups in science to support math concepts. We have the kids ActiveVote, and then we can save that data and then determine from there how kids are meeting specific math indicators. We do the same thing in World Studies for reading.
There's feedback for me also in that I can look back and say, this is how I need to drive my instruction. I need to go back and reteach this topic.
We go over it again like two or three times if we don't get it.
Or I can move on. Maybe the kids have it completely covered and I don't need to spend any more time on it.
I've noticed that with the Promethean boards, a lot more kids are participating in class.
Our teachers meet departmentally weekly, and we talk about instruction, data, and kids.
So this is you guys compared to the county.
Now, what we've really done is taken a look at assessments. So like question by question, we'll break it down.
And find out how the students perform. We can break it down to any demographic we want to see how one particular subgroup performed.
It's not good enough just to teach, in the olden days, teaching to the middle. You know, we need to teach to all of our students because all of our students need to be successful, and not just successful, but at high levels.
Our individual data gets entered into the computer by our data specialists here at the school, and then we can compare it to any other school or the county overall.
And then we have team-level data chats, where we take some of the information we gather from the departments, and we talk about the individual student.
You grab lunch and you go to a class, and they help you do stuff or that you don't understand.
And that actually what helps to drive the instruction, because we have intervention programs during the day and after school, and we really try to gear our instruction to meeting the needs of those kids.
Last year during math, I was having some difficulties, and then my teacher asked me to come in for lunch, and yeah, it helped me a lot because I managed to pull up my grade by a lot.
I think if you'd ask any student in our building, you know, they can see the change in terms of, you know what, every staff member does believe in my ability, and they believe in their abilities, and we show them their own data, and we don't hide it from them. You know, this is where your reading level is now. This is where we want you to be in 3 years. You know, how can we help you out? And I think the students appreciate that.
So the data chats for us have become part of our culture.
Teachers take an ownership of making sure our kids succeed. The students take an ownership over their learning and succeeding. You know, administration supporting and taking ownership of everyone's results. So I'm happy. A lot of high expectations here at Wood.
Outreach is something that we always strive to improve upon so that our student achievement can go up even more. And this year we started study circles looking at erasing race and ethnicity as a barrier to student success.
Oftentimes I'm somewhat uncomfortable because I don't speak Spanish in trying to talk with the Hispanic parents. And so that kind of helped me bridge through that.
How many of you are taking Spanish? Ooh, that's a lot of people who potentially can vie for my job one day.
We had a Hispanic Heritage Symposium. And we had speakers come out and talk about how they have worked in different careers and different technologies. And we opened it up for parents to come in and support their kids. We also had, at the end of that, student presentations on different countries.
We certainly are trying to educate the parents and having them feel welcome coming into the school at any time. What we did new this year was to have a parent academy included in our PTA meetings. It's a very good way to learn not only more about the school itself, but schools in general.
For any parent, it's just important for them to stay linked with the educational system, be it the teacher, the assistant principals, the principal, the counselors. They will gain from you, the parent, because you have a better understanding of your child than they do. And then you will gain from them because they'll also pick up strengths that maybe we aren't aware of.
Having this environment that is collaborative where people want to work together, they want to have discussions together about what's best for kids. It's very positive. And I think it's the best job in the world.
School's awesome. Yeah.